students, I welcome you to Others Vidyalaya e-learning program. I am Stella from Others Vidyalaya English department. Today's class is unit 1, supplementary The Tempest. It is written by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare was born in Stratford-upon-Avon, England. His period was 1564 to 1616. He was an English poet, playwright, and actor. He was the world's preeminent dramatist. He wrote 37 plays, 154 sonnets, and 2 long poems. The play Tempest was written between 1610 and 1611. Many critics and historians believe that it is the one of the lost plays of Shakespeare. It is considered as one of Shakespeare's well-written plays. It is believed that the play The Tempest was based on an actual wreck of a ship called Sea Ventures of Bermuda that was headed to Virginia. There is a strong evidence that Shakespeare used elements of the story of the wreck. Characters of the story: Prospero, Duke of Milan, main character. Miranda, heroine of the story, Prospero's daughter. Sygorax, a witch and an old enemy of Ariel. Ariel, chief of all spirits. Caliban, ugly monster and son of Sygorax. Antonio, Prospero's younger brother. Gonzalo, kind lord of Prospero's court. King of Naples. Alonso, enemy of Prospero. Ferdinand, hero of the story and son of Alonso. Theme of the story: forgiveness is one form of revenge. Let us see the synopsis of the story now. The Tempest is a famous play of William Shakespeare and an extract from Charles Lamb's Tales from Shakespeare. Prospero and his daughter Miranda spent 12 years in an island. With his magic power, Prospero releases the spirits imprisoned by Sygorax, so they serve him with gratitude. Ariel, the chief of the spirits, fulfills commands of Prospero. Prospero finds a ship in which his cruel brother Antonio and the king of Naples, Alonso, are traveling. Obeying the command of Prospero, Ariel creates a tempest. All of them are brought to different places of the island. Prospero orders Ariel to bring Ferdinand, the prince of Naples. Miranda and Ferdinand fall in love at first sight. And Prospero tests Ferdinand and fixes his marriage with Miranda. Ariel tortures Alonso and Antonio and makes them confess for their sin against Prospero. Prospero forgives them. All of them return to Milan, the Duke of Prospero. Ariel and other spirits are set free. Dear children, let us see the detail of the story. There was an island in the sea. the only inhabitants are living beings, of which were an old man named Prospero and his daughter Miranda, a very beautiful young lady. She came to this island so young that she had no memory of having seen any other human face than her father's. They lived in a cave made out of a rock. It was divided into several apartments, one of which Prospero called his study. There he kept his books, which chiefly treated of magic. By virtue or goodness of his art, he had released many good spirits from a witch called Sigourus, who had them imprisoned or captive in the bodies of large trees. These gentle spirits were ever after obedient to the will of Prospero. Of these, Ariel was the chief. Ariel took rather too much pleasure in tormenting or giving physical and mental pain an ugly monster called Caliban, because he was the son of his old enemy Sigourus. Caliban was employed like a slave to fetch wood and to the most laborious offices, and Ariel had the charge of compelling him to these services. With the help of these spirits, Prospero could command the winds and the waves of the sea. By his orders, they rise a violent storm, in the midst of which he showed his daughter a fine large ship, which he told her was full of living beings like themselves. Dear children, I read some passage from the book. It is very simple to understand. Anyway, I explain this passage again. There was an island in the sea. Prospero and his daughter were the only living beings there. Miranda was a very beautiful lady. She came to the island so young. She did not see any other human face except her father. They lived in a cave. It was divided into several apartments. Prospero kept one room as his study, where he kept his magic books. By the art of goodness, he had released many good spirits from Sigourus. These spirits were obedient to the will of Prospero. Ariel was the chief of all spirits. Ariel was getting pleasure to torture Caliban because he was the son of Sigourus. Prospero could command the winds and waves of the sea with the help of these spirits. One day, in the midst of the violent storm, Prospero showed his daughter a large ship which was full of living beings like themselves. "Oh, my dear father," said she, "if by your art you have raised this dreadful storm, have pity on their sad distress. See, the vessels will be dashed to pieces. Poor souls, they will all perish." Perish means die. "Be not so amazed, daughter Miranda," said Prospero. "There is no harm done. I have so ordered it that no person in the ship shall receive any hurt. What I have done has been in care of you, my dear child. You are ignorant. Can you remember? a time before you came to the cell. I think you cannot, for you were not than 3 years of age. 12 years ago, Miranda continued Prospero, I was Duke of Milan, and you were a princess, and my only heir. I had a younger brother whose name was Antonio, to whom I trusted everything. My brother Antonio, being thus in possession of my power, began to think himself the Duke indeed. The opportunity I gave him of making himself popular among my subjects awakened in his bad nature a proud ambition to deprive me of my dukedom. This he soon effected with the aid of King Naples, a powerful prince who was my enemy. Whereof, said Miranda, did you they not are the stories? My child, answered her father, they dare not. So dear was the love that my people bore me. Antonio carried us on board a ship when we were some leagues out at sea. He forced us into a small boat without either tackle, sail or mast. There he left us, as he thought, to perish. But a kind lord of my court, one Gonzalo, who loved me, had privately placed in the boat water, provisions, apparel, and some books which I prize above my dukedom.
Oh, my father, said Miranda, what a trouble must I have been to you then? No, my love, said Prospero. You were a little angel that did preserve me. Your innocent smiles made me bear up against my misfortune. Our foot lasted till we landed on this desert island, since when my chief delight has been in teaching you, Miranda, and well you profited my instruction.
Heaven thank you, my dear father, said Miranda. Now tell me, sir, your reason for raising this sea storm. Know then, said her father, that by means of this storm, by enemies, the king of Naples and my cruel brother are cast ashore upon this island.
Dear children, do you understand the above reading? Wait, I'll explain. Seeing the midst of the ship in the storm, Miranda requested her father to have pity on them. And she said people would die due to dreadful storm. Prospero told Miranda that he had ordered that the person in the ship should not get any hurt. And he had done all for Miranda. He asked Miranda if she could remember a time before they came to that island, and he added that she was 3 years of age that time. Prospero started to say his flashback. Before 12 years, he was the king of Milan, and Miranda was a only heir of him. He trusted his brother Antonio, who had the possession of his power. Antonio thought himself as a king. By his bad nature, he deprived the kingdom of Prospero with the help of Naples, who was Prospero's enemy. Antonio carried them on a board, a ship. He forced them into a small boat without any tackle to sail. But King Lord Gonzalo helped Prospero. Hearing the tragedy of his father,
Miranda asked whether she was troubled to him in that time. Prospero answered that she is the only person who preserved him in that difficult situation. And he added that the teaching of Miranda was the only delight in that time.
Miranda asked Prospero the reason for raising violent storm. Prospero said that his enemies, the king of Naples and his cruel brother, were cast ashore upon that island.